each other. I hope it gets down to a brawl right now.
The two greatest athletes in the history of the World Wrestling Federation going at it at WrestleMania. Now the question is, Shawn Michaels, in your mind, do you believe that the Hitman Bret Hart is the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be?
No way!
First of all, I would like to say that there is not a person in this building that has more respect for this man right here than Shawn Michaels.
What?
I most definitely believe that the Hitman is the best there was. And I suppose that only time will tell, because I can't foresee the future, but I believe he may possibly be the best that there ever will be. But the one thing I do have to question, and again, with all due respect to you, Bret, I can't believe in my own heart that right now, at this time, in 1996, that you are the best there is, because I believe that that spot is owned by the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
Everyone has to have confidence.
Here we go.
Confidence, unquestionably a very important part, Bret Hart, of your reign as the WWF champion. And indeed, how do you size up your challenge?
Well, with all due respect, Shawn Michaels, I think you're one of the greatest wrestlers I've ever had the privilege of watching. And I know that in the last 5 months, being the World Wrestling Federation champion, without a doubt, have been the hardest 5 months of my career. And I've taken a lot of punishment from some big guys. And it's awful tough wrestling guys that are 6'9 and 7 feet tall. But no matter what, I really, really look forward to an opportunity to step in the ring and show exactly why it is that I am the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
Oh, listen to these people.
You know, there's a lot of people that misunderstand things. It's not my job to beat you. Being the World Wrestling Federation champion, it's your job to beat me. Now, in this match, Shawn Michaels, I just want you to understand one thing, because, like I say, I got nothing but respect for you. I think you're great. But once this bell rings, once they sound that bell, I'm gonna hit you with everything but the kitchen sink, and you're in for the biggest dogfight you've ever seen in your whole life.
I think everyone would concur with that, and unquestionably, with that in mind, conditioning, both mentally as well as physically, will play a huge part in this match.
Well, certainly conditioning will, and I know that he has had nothing but tough opponents one after another. But you know something? I haven't done so bad myself lately. I've been beat up by 9 thugs. I've been beat up by 7-foot people. And you know something? I'm still standing here looking as good as I ever have. And Hitman, once again, I guess you and I could sit here and blow smoke at each other, because we do have a lot of respect for each other. But the fact of the matter is, you want to know about conditioning? Well, let me ask you something. Take a look at that. Does it look like I'm in the best condition of my life, or is it just my imagination?
There's no question. You're going to have to give it your all, as you have so many, many times before, Bret Hart. What kind of shape are you going to be in?
We ever see that little pink rabbit on those Energizer commercials?
The Energizer Bunny.
I just keep going and going and going.
Hey, wait a minute.
Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen, the president of the World Wrestling Federation.
What's he doing here?
Ladies and gentlemen, Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Something's fitting to happen. Whenever this guy shows up, something happens. And it's not always good either.
Piper, may I please? Thanks. Go have yourself a seat.
He's got a seat, all right.
You know, first of all, I was listening, and my job as the president of the WWF is to represent you people and make sure you get a fair shake on every fight that's coming up in WrestleMania 12 on the 31st in Anaheim. And the first thing that I do not like is when they announce Bret Hart's name, I hear people boo.
Yeah,
you don't
me.
Boo a guy like this. Hang on. I didn't come here to say what's popular. I come here to tell the truth. You don't boo a guy that's been 3 times world champion. Why, one time I even heard this guy beat Roddy Piper. I don't know. I wasn't there.
All right.
You don't boo a guy like this. This kid, his whole life, has been dying to win the World Wrestling Federation title, has done everything in his power, has been on the mat, has grappled ever since he's been this high for this one chance. But I'll tell you something. There's something that everybody's missing, because March 31st, Anaheim, is the night to fight. If I'm the WWF president, there's going to be a winner here. There ain't going to be no kind of tight pulling, no DQs, nothing like that.
Well,
you're talking about conditioning. First of all, you don't judge a book by its cover. So yes, you got wonderful abs. That don't mean nothing.
That's right.
You've been beat up a couple of times. You know, it's time. Anybody can have a lucky night and catch a fall. So this is the way it's gonna be in your match for the WWF title. It's not a one-fall match. It's the man that can get the most falls on the other man will become the WWF champion. Do you have a problem with that?
I don't have a problem with that.
Do you have a problem with that?
I don't have a problem. How long of a match are we talking about?
You hear this, McMahon?
Yes, I've just joined you again here on headset and...
1 hour!
Whoa!
Oh, my goodness!
No timeouts! No nothing! Because I gotta tell you something. These two guys right here can perform, and there's somebody that's gonna make them, and that's me. March 31st, Anaheim, the one who gets the most falls wins this belt. Until then, boys, you might as well shake hands now, because you're gonna hate each other after that.
My goodness, a one-hour match, an Iron Man match, if you would. And whoever wins the most falls in 1 hour wins the WWF Championship in there. Two great competitors.